Hey guys, here Mark the Geek. In this video, I have a very cool product that I wanted to try. It's called the Skiva MediaFlow HDX2 micro USB / MHL 2 HDMI cable. And what this cable is supposed to do is connect your phone to your LCD TV via HDMI. Like you see right here, let's go ahead and take it out. This is what you're gonna get. This is a pretty long cable. This is almost like, I could say, like 6 feet long. It's very, very long. Look at that. That is very, very long. And like you see, you got the HDMI right here, the port. Let's go to your TV. This goes to your cell phone, just like that, to your cell phone. And to power everything, you need any charger, the charger of your phone or any other charger, so you can connect the other end to the power outlet. And that's it. That way, that's good, because that way, while you have your phone connected to your TV, your phone will not discharge, so it will keep on charging. So that way you could be playing games, watching videos, anything, and without worrying of it discharging, because you will not run out of charge because thanks to this. So let's go ahead and try it out on my TV. Okay, so here now on the TV, I just connected the HDMI part of the cable to the TV. I also connected the power part, the one that goes to the USB charger, I connected to the wall. Now I'm gonna go ahead and connect right here to the TV. See how long it takes for it to connect to the TV. Like you see right here, it says video out connection. If you swipe down, it says video out connected HDMI. That is good. That is right away, that's good. Right now I'm using here Sense 5, if I'm not mistaken. No, this is Apex launcher. And like you can see, this is how it looks. It automatically goes to landscape. That way it fits the TV practically completely. If I go ahead and try Sense, this is Sense, so let's go ahead and try Sense. Sense will keep you like that. But let me go ahead and try go back to Apex launcher. You could use any launcher. If I use Smart Launcher, which is one of my favorite launchers, this is how it looks. It looks amazing. Looks very cool on the TV, on the big TV. But let's go ahead and go to Apex, since it's one of the most used launchers. And let's go ahead here and show you guys. Let's go to gallery. I'm gonna go here to gallery, and let's go ahead and search for some photos and videos. Like you see right away, you can see pictures from my gallery, and I could go ahead here and just like that start swiping pictures. Very cool. Nice. Like you see, very, very nice, very fluid. Also, I could go ahead and watch videos. Let me go ahead and see, put a play a video here from, okay, here, one of my Zoe videos. Okay. I could go ahead back up over here. Like you can see, it works perfectly. Very nice. Audio is coming out from my home theater, because my home theater is connected to the TV. So it's working very, very good. Let's go ahead and get out. Let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Now, the most excited thing I want to try is video games. So right now, I'm going to go ahead, since I have the MOGA controller, I'm going to connect my MOGA controller. I'm going to turn it on. Okay, so now let's go ahead and open the MOGA app. That way it connects a lot faster. MOGA app. Okay, so it's connected. Yes, it's already connected here to the app. Let's put the phone down. Okay, so I put my phone on a stand, that way you guys can see it right there while I'm recording over here. And since this is Bluetooth, the MOGA controller is Bluetooth, you guys can just go through my games. And let me go ahead and play a game from here. I'm gonna see, I could go ahead and try either. I'm trying to go over here. Okay, so it loaded. And right away you can see the configuration of my remote, of my control pad. And I can see it's working very good, very fast. And it's very exciting to be able to do this. It's like having a portable console that you could hook up to any TV now. So right here, let me see if I could, yeah, I could navigate very easily. Go ahead and choose a game, choose a race. Let me go ahead and choose this one. And let me go ahead and choose a car. Okay, so look at that. Not bad. So right here, I'm just gonna go ahead and play a little bit so you guys can see. Of course, do not expect it to look like a PlayStation 3, because keep in mind, this is still, okay, this is still a phone, but it's, you know, it's very possible to play very good games here using the MHL cable. Baby. So not bad, huh? So let's go ahead now and go ahead and try another game here. Okay, so this is respawnables here, like you see right here. Go ahead, throw grenades. Honestly, it's pretty cool that you can actually do this with the phone. Yeah, got killed there. So, like you can see, guys, that's it. Just wanted to show you guys how cool this app, this cable actually works on the HTC One. And if I'm not mistaken, it works on almost any phone there is in the market. So, I think it's worth buying. The cable is very cheap, too. The cable just cost me, $13 on Amazon, which is not bad for everything you will be able to do with it. So $13 just to experiment, I don't think it's bad. And the great thing is that you can use it for future phones as well. You don't have to be stuck to your current phone. So this is something that's going to be working on different phones that you buy. So I hope you guys liked the video. This was a look at the MHL cable for connected with the HDMI. And it works perfectly good. Till next time, guys.